Abilities, abilities, abilities. Let's talk about it. Which ones are good? Which ones are bad? Which ones work? Which ones don't? Which ones are worth it? Who gets what? How do I put them? All this, that, blah, blah. Let's figure it out right now. If you guys want to watch me play live, twitch.tv/dub. That link is below. Any offense, defense, special teams, coaching adjustments, sliders, anything you need can be found at MaddenTurf.com. You guys can check that out live. Also, every Wednesday, all my Twitch subs get a lab session stream for free if you are subbed to my Twitch channel. Man, so if you guys want a free lab session, check out everything that's going through my mind, a way for you guys to talk to me, a way for you guys to ask me any question about Madden live on Wednesday nights on my Twitch, so you guys can check that out as well. But man, abilities, they have this new ability point system, man, and honestly, it's awesome. I love everything about it, man. If you want to get that edge stud ability, it's going to cost you 3 points. And man, that's a lot. You have 10 total both on offense and defense, and figuring out the best combination is pretty much the biggest puzzle, or, you know, just biggest thing we got to figure out while we're playing this game, man. And I'll tell you, I really like the defense in this game. I like the way the zones play. I like the way the underneath ones, you can change the distance of your yellows, of your purples, of your clouds, everything. But the blues are a little bit weak, I'll be honest. You can throw at them even deep down the field, man. And I will tell you something. The best corner in this game, I think, is Asante Samuel. If you guys ask me what secondary player is a must-have, Asante Samuel, former Eagle great, is definitely on that list. So let's take a look at this card. I'll show you guys this crazy combination I put on Asante Samuel and see if you guys like it, man, because I think it's something I want to keep live, I want to keep working with, but I think it's going to be something that really boosts everybody's defense, mine included as well, man. But let's take a look at this card now. Asante Samuel, he's a 91 overall. I use lockdown chemistry on defense for my secondary, so he has boosted zone, boosted everything. So let's take a look at his card. 92 speed. I have 40 sprinters, so he's 92 speed. We see it with the 93 zone, the 86 man, 93 play rec. Just absolutely a dog when it comes to zone. Now, he is 5'10", which is a little bit short, and I have realized that, you know, I mean, I've always been a height guy and everything like that, and that's something that, you know, I've realized some of these short cards can kind of ball, whether it's Asante Samuel, Dre Bly, as you guys saw in my other video, or Tyrann Mathieu actually balls out now for me as well. But the abilities I'm going to use, the combo is Acrobat, which I think is awesome on all my DBs. I actually have 5 Acrobats on the field right now. I have no D-line abilities. My D-linemen are naked. I have 5 abilities in my secondary as far as Acrobat. Now, Acrobat will get you to dive and catch interceptions, dive and swat. Pretty much go crazy if you're near the ball and you can lay out for it. I really like it, especially on my users. I like that. Now, this is the one that I tried, man. It's deep in zone knockout. So, improved reaction and knockouts in deep inside zones. Now, obviously, he's a corner, so he's going to be on the outside. Now, what I'm going to do in this game and with this combination of deep zone knockout and Acrobat, I am going to put him in free safety. I am going to put him in a deep third in the middle of my field and let this combination really take over and see if it's worth it to use this combination. Is this deep end zone knockout really going to be that good? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this safety, put him in a deep middle, and bring him down close to the line. That way, he's not too far back to react, and he's able to really jump on the ball. Let's see if these two abilities work. Now, the reason why I use Asante Samuel and not Bob Sanders or Tyrann Mathieu or whatever other safety, Adrian Wilson, the best safeties in the game, Atwater, is because the deep end zone knockout costs more AP on other players. If you're a zone archetype corner, it only costs 2 AP, 2 of your salary, your ability cap points only. Otherwise, it's 3. Rod Woodson is a great example, man. Rod Woodson is a lot more physical than Asante Samuel, can probably play the safety position a little bit better than him, but this particular ability costs 3 cap on him rather than 2 on Asante. So what I'm doing, I'm going to put Asante a free safety. We're going to bring him down in the box. Let's see if he goes crazy and helps me win this game. All right, boys, so we're playing Shacoby. If you guys have watched any Madden over the last week, you know Shacoby is a leaderboard demon. I think this is my second game against Shacoby that's actually on my YouTube, man. So he's a tough opponent, somebody I can really see if this ability is going to work. Now, he's doing this contain blitz. If you guys have run into this where they pinch and crash the D-tackles and just put contains and they disengage and really get stupid under pressure, it's going to be patched I believe tomorrow. If you're watching this video, it's probably already patched. So for me, I feel it's foolish to run a defense like this that you know is not going to be available for you tomorrow. You know, but you know, kids have to do what they have to do to be competitive. And Shakobi is doing this disengage, contain glitch, which is easy, man. If you guys do want to do it, you just... Any three down lineman as I convert a huge 4th and 10 early in the game. Tyreek Hill, big catch for him. Any defensive line with 3D linemen right there, just pinch, crash down, and contain. Your contains will go to the middle, and they'll like be glitchy around the offensive lineman. It's going to be really hard for your opponent to block this. But we get a big 3rd and 19, I believe. We hit this out route right here to Julio Jones. Get close to field goal range, but we're going to go for it on 4th down. He sends a little blitz, and I throw that way too early. And throw an interception to Adrian Wilson. Timing was off right there. That's what the blitz can do for you. Looking back, I mean, I really had time. The blitz was going to get picked up. Now, Shakobi is going to run a tight offset. It's obviously, if you guys watch me play, it is something I'm very, very familiar with. And it's pretty much revolve around this right here, the corner route. Now, as a Madden nerd, I know the corner route is on the opposite side of the running back. Have to make sure I go out there and guard that corner route every time. Now, right there, you see it, right? Boom, I run out there and guard that corner route. We get a we get an intentional grounding from throwing the ball away while he's in the pocket. Now, the one thing about this game with the runoff right now, it is very tough as he throws a wheel route. There's 20 yards down the field on 3rd and 23. It is very hard, and then he hits the corner route again. Pretty easy drive, the first one. It's very hard to stop or to set up your defense, because all these opponents, they're all up against the clock with only 10 seconds to the line. So the quick snap is very viable. It's a part of a lot of people's offenses. In fact, this year we can snap the ball faster than any other year out of the huddle from Madden. This is the fastest play call to snap Madden has ever been. So quick snapping is a huge part of Madden 21. It's something I try to get better at, and I have incorporated it in my ebook that's on Madden Turf. As we throw this out route to Julio, he gets hit right there, drops the ball. That is the million coin limited Julio Jones. People ask me all the time as I hit the flat to Finley right here. They ask me all the time, is Julio worth it? Honestly, no. I don't think any card is worth a million coins in Madden at all. Flat route again to Finley. But he is a dog. So if you guys had the luxury of having that many coins, try out that Julio Jones, man. But I said, don't worry if you don't have him, because it's not that big a deal. As we see Julio eating again, 3-yard line. We're getting close to halftime here. Got to use some clock. And I have Bo Jackson, big boy Bo right there. So those are the two biggest cards, you know, just upgrades I have on my team right now. Bo Jackson, Julio Jones. Still running Lamar quarterback. There's no reason to have any other quarterback in the game. If you don't have that mobility, you are missing out offensively, man. Find a way to get that ability or that mobility on your field as we give up the corner route again. It gets to a point in this game where I say, you know what? I'm just going to guard this corner route. That's all you want to throw. Boom, right there in front of Asante. And I need to move Asante closer to the box. That's what I need to do. And he goes, I told you, that's enough. I don't want any more. You throw the ball in there. You're not throwing to the corner route. Throw to anybody else. That's one thing. Bill Belichick, I talk about all the time. Take away the number one thing your opponent wants to do. He wants to throw that corner route. It's not happening anymore this rest of this game. Throw a drag, throw a slant, throw anything else. But I'm not giving up the corner route. I go up top for a corner route, and Julio can't moss Asante right there. Forcing things now. There's very little time left in the half here. But I can still get a field goal if I make a big play. Just give myself an option as I dump it off to Bo Jackson, pick up 15 yards, 10 seconds left and a half. Got to make one more dot, and I can actually get a field goal because we have the Morin Anderson with the 88 kick power, and Lamar Jackson will roll out, pick up 11 yards. I'm at the 38. This is a 55-yard field goal. Perfect kick power. Morin Anderson right over the uprights. Money, halftime, 10-7. I have a lead. I'm kicking the ball off, so I got to play defense. One, I have to stop the corner route, and I have to move this Asante into the box so we see if this ability can make a play, man. Because if he's 30 yards back, he's not going to jump anything. That's one thing I'll tell you guys, man. If you want your deep blues to be a little bit more aggressive, bring them closer to the box, man. It's something Madden players have been doing for a long time, not only in this game, but in any Madden pretty much I've ever played. But you will be susceptible to other things as he almost hits the drag right there, but we get some pressure. And like I said, I'm guarding the corner route. There's nothing else he can throw to. Tyreek Hill coming up with a huge catch in traffic. Tyrann Mathieu there. I wish Tyrann Mathieu had a little more boots to be able to hit. I honestly wish that, but he's been a very good card for me. We give up a corner route right there. He went two corner routes right there. Kind of mixed it up a little bit. But we're going to cover it again. Really nowhere for him to go if I covered his corner route the right way. Rolls out, throws it up top, but there's Rod Woodson knocking the ball away from the running back. I believe that's their second and 10. Another slant right there. So I got to play a little bit more aggressive on those slants and guard the corner route. Maybe shade down, guard the corner route. Have my yellow zones playing a little more physical. Once again, he hits that post over the middle. I have to bring us. And when I say bring Asante down, I'm saying literally next to my linebackers. I'm running nickel normal this game, so I have two linebackers. But as you see before that snap, I want it to almost look like I have three. And right there, he threw into the entire Eagles team and did not get interception. That's what we want. And next play, again, he threw. That time Asante went crazy, but he swatted. You see that diving swat? Those are the things you get with Acrobat. Would have loved the diving pick. Honestly, if he was taller, his player model might reach out and grab that rather than reach out, dive, and swat the ball right there. But we're closing in and getting into the fourth quarter here. I have to go down and get some points to take the lead in this game. We see Lamar rolling out again. We're going to hit this corner route to Julio Jones. Julio Manduli, 6'3", able to reach out and catch that before the DB could get it. Next play again. He's too slow to keep up with Julio Manduli inside this 15-yard line right here. Next play. Hey, three times the charm. Julio Manduli. Touchdown. Just that easy. 1-2-3 plays. Find the money man. Get into the end zone. Now, like I said, those plays were great, but you know, Jerry Rice probably could have did all those plays, really. But it looks better when it's a million coin card making plays for you. But you know, now we gotta play defense. I feel like I'm okay. I feel like some of the passes he's thrown could be an interception. So I just have to keep this corner route. There we go again. Boom. And we get the hit stick from Adrian Wilson right there over the top. Got to move my safeties down. Can't let him throw that post route anymore like that. That's going to be the only real route he has to go to in these situations. Goes to it again and holds on in all that traffic. The reason I don't always have Asante down there is because, honestly, he's getting rid of the ball so fast. And my main concern is make sure I'm on my user to take away this corner route. So moving Asante down in the box is pretty much my last adjustment. And right here, Tyrann Mathieu breaks up the corner route to the wide side of the field. We're closing on a two-minute warning. Third and 10 right here. He hits another slant in front of my purple zone right there. But we're cool. We're up 7. We just got to play defense. Keep him out of the end zone. He only has one touchdown. We've been playing great defense since then. And here we go. We're going to move Asante up close to the linebackers. And right here, he's going to make the play of the game. Just reacting, diving, laying out, and sealing the game with a huge interception right there. Giving me the ball back. Under a minute left in the game. One first down will end it. And that's what Bo Jackson does right there. Lower his shoulder. We're just going to keep pounding the ball. That's the type of play I want to see. Those are the plays I want. Even though there was a streak to run the deep third off, he came back and jumped that post route laid out for us. So the combination of deep in knockout and Acrobat really made that interception for me. So this is what Madden 21 is about, figuring out what abilities you want to use and where you want to use them. So if any abilities you guys want me to try out or any abilities you guys are using, please let me know in the comments below. And if you like this type of video, please hit that like button.